The second topic of this lecture is the reading and writing a data in the JSON format. We already talked in one of the lectures that we can use a JSON to save and load the data. The load was a JSON.load and the saving was a JSON.dump. Here we have a large number of the data, which is the data of the countries and the population. So we can use a JSON library by calling it import JSON, and the name of the file that we have is a population_data.json, and we use a view block. So here we have load this object using a JSON load, and then we have the pop data. So pop data, we just printed the first one, and you can see that is a list, and it has a dictionary in it. Its dictionary has a key on the name, which is the name of the country apparently, and each has a country code that has a year and the value, that this value represents the population at this year. So you can see the one country is repeated multiple times, and so for each different years. Here we have the year equal to 1960, here we have for 1961, and then we have for 62, 63, so it shows the name of the country and its population for a different year. So here we want to have some analysis of the population of these countries, and how we can use a PyGelf library to plot the graph in the maps. Now, we get the population for only 2000, so we have a dictionary. We look through the Py data that we have, and we are interested in the only 2010. Remember, we put this one as a string because the data is a string. You remember, you can see this is a string, so this quotation represent that the data that we have is a string, and then we are adding the country names. This is a dictionary and this is a key, and so the value of this key is added to country name, and then we are inverting the value that represents the population to the float, and then the float is an integer, so then this represents the population, and then we are printing that the population of each country is this one. Remember the print function. In the concatenation, we have to have the same data type. So this is a string, this is a string. So this number should be converted to a string. Once we have done this, we get this information for each country. We can use a PyGel to get code of the countries. Because PyGel has been released a new version, you may get errors once you use the textbook codes. You can use import countries from pygel.maps.org. So this is, has all the information that you need. So whenever you see in the textbook from pygel.i18 import countries, you just need to change it to the pygel.maps.org. So this is the updated version that works. Each country can be represented as a code. You can see the country codes, and this dictionary has the keys, and we are working on the keys and representing the two digit code for each country. For example, you have AD for Andorra, AE for UAE. So you can see each country is represented by the two digit code. So this for loop goes through countries keys. So this is a dictionary that we loop through the keys, and we have the country code and then the name of the countries. Now we use the same thing. We are defining a function from the same library. We are using the for loop in the country items. So this returns key and values. So the code is a key, the name is a country name. If the name of the country is then equal to whatever we parse into the function is equal, then we return the code. Otherwise, we do not return anything. So this is a function that if the country code is available in these countries, in this function that we have, we get the code of the country. That's a 2GD. Otherwise, we make nothing as a none. So here we are calling for three different countries. For Andorra, we are getting AD. For UAE, we are getting AE. And from Afghanistan, we are getting AF. So we parse a function, a name of the country into this one. And if the name of the country is available in this country items, we get the code of the country. Otherwise, we do not get anything. The PyGAL has a very good library, map countries that we have. So here we define WM as the PyGAL maps.wordword. So this is a library that defines the map of the world, and we define the title of this one, which is North, Central, and South America. And we add this as a North America, and the countries inside them is Canada, Mexico, and the US. So this is based on this. So
add function is a function that adds set of the countries in the subcategories. For example, here in North America, we have Canada and Mexico and US, and you can see they are colored purple. And then one more add function, we have the Central America that has Brazil and Guatemala and some other countries that you can see. So you have the first the categories and comma, and inside of the list, the 2GD country labels or country code that you have, and then we have the South America that we have other countries. So, and you can see we are saving the file as americas.svg. So this is another format that we have. So if you open the file and Americas, so if you open the file, let's say using the Google Chrome, you will see interactive, so you can see the first countries are the North America, the countries are highlighted by North America, groups are the Canada and the US and Mexico, and then the Central America, we have the Guatemala and Costa Rica, and then for the South America, we have Panama, Brazil, and Chile, and Argentina, and so on. So you can see we have three categories of the countries that we added to the map that we have. So basically, when we call this PyGAL word map, you have an empty, and then you add the countries, and also you can add more information. For example, when you click on these countries, you can show the population of each country. That we will show one more example in a moment. We can add some title, and we can add the population of the countries. So here we can use dictionaries. The population of the US is a little more than 300 million, and the Canada is 34 million. So you have the population of the countries, and we are saving the file using the render to file, and the format is .svg. So let's look at this file too. So na.population.svg. So this is a file that we have, and then let's open it by the Google Chrome. And you can see when you click on these countries, the name of the countries, you can see the population that we have, and then each country is separated with the different colors. So it's a very interactive and nice figure that we have here. The location of file is in the same location that you have your .py file, so whenever you save your program, you can find the file in the same location. That and then we can have the more complex data feature. In this example, we are categorizing the countries into the three different categories, that their population is between 0 to 10 million, between 10 to 1 billion, and 10 million to 1 billion, and more than 1 billion, into three categories. The color also shows the density of the population, world population. So we open this file, and if you click on this one, you can remove add countries. For example, if you click more than 1 million, you can see China as India is gone, but if you click on that, you can get them back. So let's say countries with 10 million to 1 billion population, so you can see most of the countries are gone.